For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
The second week of the trial part of the extradition hearing of Julian Assange ended on Friday, September 18. The week saw the defense bring more witnesses who testified on a variety of issues related to the work of Julian Assange and WikiLeaks. In a variety of ways, defense witnesses proved that the case against Assange was politically motivated. A key argument of the defense has been that for this reason, he should not be extradited to the United States. The witnesses also made it clear that he would not get a fair trial in the US and that he would probably be in jail for the rest of his life. Defense witnesses repeatedly shot down the prosecution's argument that revelations by WikiLeaks had endangered the lives of people. Multiple witnesses demonstrated how rigorous WikiLeaks standards were in processing the information. Number of witnesses revealed how important revelations by WikiLeaks had been reporting the true extent of US war crimes and brutalities in various parts of the world. Julian Assange is facing 17 charges under the Espionage Act and one charge under the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act. The charges entail a jail sentence of around 175 years. Assange is being prosecuted for working with Chelsea Manning to expose the US war crimes and atrocities in Iraq, Afghanistan, and other countries. Daniel Ellsberg is a US whistleblower who released the Pentagon Papers detailing the US involvement in Vietnam and Southeast Asia. Ellsberg strongly defended Assange comparing their work. He talked about the safeguards Assange took while releasing the documents and pointed out that he even offered to cooperate with the US government so that there would be no risk in releasing the documents. Ellsberg also shot down the prosecution argument that people's lives had been endangered by the release of documents by WikiLeaks. He rejected attempts of prosecution to differentiate his path-breaking work from that of Assange and Manning. Most importantly, he made clear that Assange would never get justice in a US court. US lawyers Louise and Durkin talked about the kind of prison sentences and treatment Julian Assange may face if he is extradited to the United States. Both the lawyers agreed that Assange, who is 49-year-old, may end up in spending his entire life in jail if he is convicted. Louise talked about the Alexandria Detention Center where Assange may be kept in if he is extradited. He could be placed in solitary confinement even before his trial begins. Louise also talked about the special administrative measures which will be used to apply pressure on Assange. Durkin spoke about the kind of pressure and coercion that the US government will apply on Assange to get him to admit guilt. All of this makes clear what kind of treatment awaits if Assange is extradited. Khalid El-Masri is a German citizen who was kidnapped from Macedonia by the CIA in 2003 and was tortured, sodomized, and force-fed in jail in Afghanistan. Some months later, the CIA discovered his was a case of mistaken identity and abandoned him in Albania. Khalid El-Masri and John Goes, a journalist who wrote about him, described the role of WikiLeaks in ensuring that he could fight for justice. Cables released by WikiLeaks also revealed the extent to which the US applied pressure on the German government to take no action despite overwhelming evidence of criminal acts by US personnel. Kerry Shangman is a lawyer who is also an expert on the Espionage case. In his testimony, he talked about how the law was always used as a tool to suppress the dissent and critiques of the US government. Shangman talked about how broad the act was and how it does not allow for a public interest clause, namely someone who reveals information under public interest can still be prosecuted under the act. He also said charging journalists under the law would be a chilling effect. He added that the use of Espionage Act was truly extraordinary and that it all signs pointed to a highly politicized prosecution. John Sloban is a founder of Iraq Body Count, an organization which documents the number of killings in Iraq following the US invasion of 2003. He explained how WikiLeaks Iraq war logs were vital in revealing information about 15,000 deaths that were not known earlier. Both Sloban and John Goes, as well as another witness, Nikki Hager, talked about the rigor with which Assange and WikiLeaks checked the documents and redacted the certain information which would have identified people and put them at risk. Several protests also took place in support of Assange.
Bien cantante, vamos a triunfar.